Hello friend, in this video I solved the day 1 data types problem of the 30 days of code in the HackerRank. So you simply go to your browser and then go to your dashboard and then go to your 30 days of code challenge, and now I press the solve challenge button, and after pressing this solve challenge button you simply come in the problem. So in this problem you simply read the tasks, what to do in this problem or what to solve in this problem. I already read this task section of this problem. So it simply says that you simply declare the three types of variable. One is integer, one is the double, and another is the string type. And after declaring the three types of variable, you simply take input from user of the three type of variable, and then you simply print the sum of the each type of variable of the existing one variable. So when we solve the problem in the editor section, you understand better. So I simply reset the code and then I expand this section, and here is the gray color section, and in this section you see that it is not changeable section. If you press the backspace, it not change. So after that, here a comment is present: declare the second integer, double and string variables. So one integer, double and character type variable are already present or already declared. So you need to declare another integer, double and string type variable. So you simply press the int and name it i1, and then declare the double type variable and name it t1, and then the character one, so I name it s1, and the size is 100. So after declaring these three type of variable, read the second comment: read and save an integer, double and string to your variable. So you simply take input from the user of the three type of variable. So I enter here and then type scanf and take the input for the integer variable. So for the integer variable, the format specifier is %d, and then the double variable, and for the double variable the format specifier is the lf. So then we take the input for the string, and you thought that you take the input by give here %s, because the %s is the format specifier of the character or string type variable. So here one problem is occurred. What? That when you give the space separated string input in the character type variable, this variable reads the string type space separated string, but when you print this, it's not printed. So here is one problem occur. That's why we take input here by another method, which is percentile, and then give a star, and then give the bracket, and then backslash n, and then another percentile, and then bracket, and the forward slash n, sorry, before the forward slash n you simply press this symbol, and then the format specifier is completed, and after that you simply press the comma here and then type s1. So you take the input for all the type of variable: integer, double and character. Here is the integer, it is the double, and it is for character, not string type. So after that, here one comment is present: to print the sum of the both integer variable on a new line. So I simply type the printf in this section and press the percentile d, and then print the I plus I1. So it is print the sum of the two integer type variable. And after that it says that print the sum of the double variable on a new line. So you simply printf and then percentile lf, and then simply enter the d plus d1, and it's print the sum of the two double type variable. But one problem is here. In this problem it says that the print the double variable to a scale of one decimal place. So you have to print one decimal place of the sum of double variable. So you give the point and one, it simply prints the one decimal place. So after that another comment is present. So concatenate and print the string variable on a new line. So you simply print the concatenations of the two string variable. So you simply print the percentile s for the s, and then another percentile s, and then give here s comma s1, and the final comment is the s variable above should be printed first. So I simply print the s variable first and all the output in the new line. So I simply forward slash and n, so here also a forward slash and n. So after that you simply press the run the code and your code is running, and here shows that congratulations page. So that means your code is right, and after that you press the submit code for checking some additional test cases. So here shows that the test case 0 and test case 1 success. So after that here is the 30 days of code challenge. We solve the day 0 and day 1 problem, and then we get the one batch. So here the batch shows and the virtual flower is falling here. So thanks for watching. If you like my video, please press the like button and don't forget to subscribe my channel. So goodbye friends.